Okay, so here we're going to prove the product rule for derivatives, which says that the derivative of a product of two functions, f times g of x, so in other words, f of x times g of x, and then take the derivative of that, so put the prime, is equal to the derivative of the first function times the second function, plus the first function times the derivative of the second function. And we're going to prove this using the limit definition for derivatives. So, by the limit definition, it says that the derivative of the multiplication of these two functions, the product, is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of, remember, it's just in general, it's the function evaluated at x plus h. So in other words, wherever you see x, in this is our function, right? F times g, that's our function. Wherever you see x, you want to plug in x plus h. So it's going to be f of x plus h times g of x plus h minus just the regular function. So just f of x times g of x. And all of this is over h. Now, again, we can't just plug in h equals 0 here because you're going to get 0 over 0. We're going to have to do some algebraic manipulation. And you can see we're going to end up with what we want in the end, which is this derivative. And there's a couple different ways you can do this. One way is we can add and subtract the same thing. And what this thing is it's not completely obvious. If you hadn't known this proof and you were just doing it on your own, you'd probably take some guessing and testing, seeing which would work. But we're going to add and subtract f of x times g of x plus h. So right here I've added it, and here I've subtracted it. And you can see this part is the same as this, and this part is the same as this. So I've just added and subtracted the same thing, so I haven't changed the original expression. But you're going to see this is going to allow us to make some factoring and some using some limit rules in order to get what we want in the end. So here's what's going to happen. Notice that these two terms here, they have a common factor of g of x plus h. So we're going to factor that out. And what's left is going to be f of x plus h minus f of x. And why are we trying to end up with f of x plus h minus f of x? Well, you notice that that's the derivative, right? That's the numerator of the derivative of f, right? And in our end, we want to end up with the derivative of f. And notice that we also have the h in the denominator. So if we can kind of get this over, like kind of split this up, we can get the derivative of f kind of lurking in the shadows there. And notice here, both of these terms have an f of x in them. If we factor that out, we're going to have f of x in the front multiplied by g of x plus h minus g of x. And again, similar idea. We're trying to get this numerator of the derivative because in our final expression, we're going to have the derivative of g in there. And so now we're going to use some limit rules. So first off, you may not have to show all of these if you really want, but I want to show each step so we can see what's actually going on. So we're going to split up this fraction, right? This h can be applied to, there's two terms in the numerator, right? There's this term, and there's this big term, and we can apply the h to both of them, right? This is the same thing, right? If you had these two fractions and you want to add them together, you just add the numerators and combine them and get back to here. And now that we have the sum of two things, right? That's the limit of a sum of two things is the sum of the limits. So it's the limit as h approaches 0 of this big thing plus the limit as h approaches 0 of this big thing. And we can use the product rule for those individual parts, right? So g of x plus h times this. So we can kind of bring that g of x plus h out in the front, so to speak. So we split it up into g of x plus h and f of x plus h minus f of x over h. Again, why are we doing this? Because we want to get this derivative of f here. And similarly on the right, we're going to use the product rule for limits to split this up into f of x and g of x plus h minus g of x over h, again, because we want to get this derivative of g here. So now we just have to evaluate these limits. So the first one here, limit as h approaches 0 of g of x plus h. Well, here we can just plug in h equals 0, and no harm, no foul. Plug it in, we just get g of x. Here, this is, by definition, the limit definition for derivative of f. So in other words, f prime of x. Over here, limit as h approaches 0 of f of x. Well, there is no h in the expression, so all it is f of x. And limit as h approaches 0 here, again, this is the definition of the derivative of g, and so that's just g prime of x. And so now you can see what this is equal to is g of x times the derivative of f plus f of x times the derivative of g. I just kind of wrote this spaced out, and I'm just going to bring them together. No algebraic change here. And again, this is the same as our, we have g of x times f prime plus f of x times g prime. Again, that's the same here. I just flipped the two, right? down here we have g of x times f prime, but multiplication we know you can switch the order, and so that's equal to our product rule. And so there you go. So what do we do here? We use the limit definition of derivative for the product of two functions. We added and subtracted the same thing, which is, again, not very intuitive, but it does help us in some proofs. And in this case, it allows us to factor out certain terms in order to get that numerator of the derivative of f and g, which we want in our final answer. We can use the sum rule for limits and the product rule for limits. And then we simplify, get those derivatives, and there we go. That's our final answer.